Good morning, everyone. Welcome back. Today we have a very special tree to be working on. This is an Albizia juberson. I've grown this from one seed last year, and it has grown tremendously. I've even pruned it, so it was even bushier, but the biggest tremendous growth is on this ginormous trunk. And we're gonna be doing some hard pruning. You see, I really like this tree. I had an initial idea to create a nice, lovely, tall canopy and let the tree just grow out and prune it back slowly. But after looking at it for a little bit, I thought I can do a lot more with this tree. So it is an extremely fast grower. It is very easy to propagate. So my idea is I'm going to be propagating four of the branches up here, and then I'm gonna do a hard cut right here so that all the energy can go into swelling this arm, as well as continuing to thicken the trunk. And eventually, as we get more shoots, as we can see, I want to cut further down here and then develop a canopy at this level. I don't want this tree to be so tall. I want to bring it right back down as the tree continues to thicken out here. And then picture this maybe 3 years from now in a shallow pot with a beautifully thick trunk and a bunch of shoots coming out and a wonderful little canopy right there. I think that will be the style for this tree. The leaves are quite small, and I think it can work out. Maybe in, could be like a 10 inch pot, 12 inch pot max, cylinder round, and then just a nice trunk. Maybe after I get it out of this pot, which it's growing out, you know, this thing is fast grower. So the idea would be to kind of see if I can get the roots to broaden out sideways, kind of like a red maple. And we'll see if that works once I repot it this upcoming spring, but I don't know if I can do that. But this, again, I think it may be possible. So let's get the scissors out and let's start cutting away. Only one little cutter right here. I don't think we're gonna need anything else. And we got rooting powder, and we got the four pots of soil here that we're gonna be propagating these branches up here. Sip of coffee, very essential. And let's start trimming. So we'll do this one here. It's one. Then we're gonna do two. It's two. All right, we're gonna do three. There we go. Oh, that one came off a little bit long. All right, and this one we'll probably, let's cut it. Let's go back here. Let's give this guy a nice little runway. That's four. Boom. Tough tree. Doesn't want to let go. Wow. This thing flew literally probably 8 feet away from me. Well, there we go. We have officially pruned the Albizia quite tremendously, I may add. Let's put this aside for the time being and let's just get these guys ready to go. So, very standard. Rooting powder, and I'm actually gonna make another one because I think this little stump would grow. This is the bottom of it, so actually, we'll put that aside. We'll do that in a second, but let's get these guys in there, dab them in very nicely, and then you just stick them in the soil, just like that. Hopefully it'll hold. I propagated a couple of these before, so I have a pretty good track record with them. So I'm not worried. I think all five will take pretty easy. So I'm actually gonna go prep another pot for that little stump, and then we'll put these aside. Thank you. now that I have all those put aside, we gotta do one final touch to this tree before we can set it aside to let it do its thing. And because we cut this over here, we gotta put in a secret ingredient. Cinnamon. We don't just put it into our coffees, we put it on the tree. So if you don't have any sealants or the little putties and stuff that they use to heal little wounds, cinnamon works as a very nice antifungal remedy to put around the wound. It won't help it heal that fast, but it will keep it clean so the tree does not get infected. And there we go. Standard stuff right there. Very pretty. So I think now, over the next 2 years, this will heal up quite nicely. Hopefully it'll round out. And then this will put out some new buds. And then I'm gonna trim it back further. I'm gonna keep an eye on it, because if it's some other shoots, like there's one little shoot coming out here, but I don't wanna cut it just yet. I'm gonna trim it right there so that I don't have to worry about all this. It kinda just brings it downward, let it focus, grow out, and we're gonna cut it right back. And then we're also gonna be very excited to repot this into a shallower pot, maybe. Maybe, if not, we'll do a bigger pot so that we can actually get this trunk to really thicken out. And then, 2 years from now, yeah, we'll put it into a shallower pot as the canopy develops. And then 3 years, so then another year after that, we will be start transferring it into a actual bonsai pot. And hopefully we'll have developed some sort of canopy above here. And obviously the trunk hopefully maybe doubles. Because I mean, if it grew this big in 1 year, I think it can easily double in 3 years. And hopefully we'll start to develop the spread on the roots to kind of make it really nice so that the taper ends up being very beautiful. And that's the plan. That is the plan with this albizia. So it's a labor of love, but it's a relationship between not only you and the tree, but you and time. Who knows what can happen in the next 2 or 3 years, but we are going to try our best to see this come to fruition and allow the tree to really develop. We're going to be adding a lot of fertilizer to it this upcoming growing season, and it's going to be something beautiful to watch. So this is part one of a 3-year process with this albizia. So I hope you guys stick around long enough to see it come true. If not, I will link it 3 years from now and it'll be fine. So let me go put this back where it belongs.